the boys from Wisconsin and North Dakota and, you know, the old the states there. And he honestly believes that in this country, and I don't discount it, because I honestly believe it could be too, with Bill Fulbright talking and acting like he does, and with the rest of them. So I want to at least make an effort to present a convincing substantive material in this respect. And we have taken the Gavin theory and gone to the bottom of it, because Gavin has been a special favorite of this administration,
mm-hmm.
special favorite of McNamara's and the rest of them, and we hauled him in here, sent a plane, brought him in, and we've had it looked up and down. But what it all gets back to, Gene, in the last word, is the Walter Lippmann Fulbright argument, is we oughtn't to be there and we ought to get out.
Well, I guess that's about what it is. I say the bombing really doesn't disturb me very
these much. Other things are just these other things are just offshoots. What they really think is we oughtn't to be there and we ought to get out. Well, I know we oughtn't to be there, but I can't get out. I just can't be the architect of surrender. And I'm trying every way in the world I can to find a way to thing. But they don't have the pressure that will bring them to the table as of yet. We don't know whether they ever will. I'm willing to do damn near anything. If I told you what I was willing to do, I wouldn't have any program. Dirksen wouldn't give me a dollar to operate the war. I just can't operate in the glass bowl with all these things. But I'm willing to do nearly anything a human can do, if I can do it with any honor at all. But they started with me on Jim, you remember.
Yeah.
He was corrupt and he ought to be killed. So we killed him. We all got together and got a goddamn bunch of thugs and we went in and assassinated him. Now, we really had no political stability since then.
Yeah.
That we've had our problem. Now, this guy is doing the best job that any of the rest of them have done. He's been more stable, and he has more social consciousness, and he has more programs of this nature that we think ultimately will do it. And we think that maybe in due time, that if they would be willing to a United Nations election, and we think the people are supporting him. We've had our best pollsters. We've had the Gallups and the Harrises and the Quails all out there. They've gone into the Viet Cong areas and the other areas, and they've taken the Vietnamese and used them very carefully. And it shows that about 80% of them are anti-communist. The Buddhists and the Catholics and the rest of them, and they're not Viet Cong. And we think that if we can ever just have enough pressure on them, through attrition and otherwise, say that this can't go on a long time, that they might be willing to take their 4 points.
Mm-hmm.
And stay pretty close to them, with the exception of running us out.
Yeah.
We just say, well, we'll stay here till you have a United Nations election, or we'll have United Nations troops till you have an election. And that's what I'm trying to work up to. But they don't feel that way now, because they think they got it.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing that the most helpful thing that they think they've got is that I've got more problems on my hand than Ho's got on his, and I have with the New York Times. It's awful goddamn hard to have foreign policy they don't approve of.
Well, I think that's right.
Oh, well, you don't know, my friend. You don't see, you don't have any idea what one little column picture of a fella can do in that New York Times with a two-column biographical background, and Scotty saying you're real wise, and Kenworthy saying, you know, the editors think that except for you, this country would lose its freedom.
Yeah.
And they drop those things around, and then they hit about 4 dirty cracks at me, and then they've got it made.
I don't read the Times only about one day a week.
I do, and
I stay away from it.
I do, and I see its effect, and it has a hell of an effect.
Yeah.
It does in the government. It does in the State Department. I have no control over my State Department. Hell, I got about as much control of my State Department as you've got of the Democrats in Texas. The intelligence man calls in them and tells them what he thinks. I read yesterday where it's going to be a 7-year war, and we're going to get involved with China, and the best estimates are 7 years. So I went to the bottom of it, And I said, that's what the president's been informed, and he's been told, and so forth. I couldn't find it anywhere. And I finally found out one intelligence fellow had sat down over there and told Max Frankel that. That's in his pen. And he's a very junior man.
Yeah.
But I have to take it, and it was my aide, my authoritative presidential spokesman.
Is that right?
Yes, that happens every day. That happens every day. And so, if you will, I want Taylor to sit down and reason with you, and I'd like for it to be quiet and off the record, and I don't want to... senators saying that I'm trying to sell them a damn thing. I've read about three times where Senator McCarthy says that he wants the country to do what it needs to do, but he has never had a case for the bombing. And I want to give you whatever case we have, and you may say, well, I'm more convinced than ever we don't have a case. But I want you to be exposed to it because I have enough confidence in your fairness to believe that if you see it as I see it, that it will at least be helpful to the national pulling us together. Okay, I'll have him call you during the day. Thank you.
Waiting.